Okay, so this is our topic for today. This is the transition network. Transition network is also same as deterministic and non-deterministic parsing, where we find the states from the sentence, and then for a particular input variable, that is the semantic rule from the English grammar, for a particular semantic rule, we found another state. Like first we have a boy is eating an apple, like this. Then A is an article. By finding and from the start state, if we find article, then we go for next state A. Then we found the noun, a boy. A is an article, boy is a noun. Auxiliary verb, we can say very sweet. Okay, very sweet, eating an apple, like this. Then the auxiliary verb, the adjective or the auxiliary verb is there, then verb, article, and then an apple. So these are the states. If we have in sentence, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. If we have 7 terms in a sentence, then how we are going to form that particular sentence is called a transition network. This is also useful for sentence generation. When we are going for generating a sentence, then we identify how many terms we have to revert back to the user that have generated the query for any sentence, for any question. Then we, how we respond, then we find the particular term which has to be respond to the user and the number of state or the number of term which we are going to revert back. These terms should be arrange in a manner so that they fulfill the requirement of semantic rules. Okay, so according to English sentence, if we form that particular sentence, then we start from here according to top-down parser. At first, the noun phrase and article will make a noun phrase, a verb and auxiliary verb will make a verb phrase, and a noun and article will make a noun phrase. Again, a noun phrase and verb phrase, by combining these four, because they have made a noun, this is that stage has made a noun phrase, and this is stage has made a verb phrase. By combining these, we can make in again verb phrase, and this is a noun phrase. So the sentence is the combination of noun phrase and verb phrase. At the end, we are getting the whole sentence. Okay, a transition network may consist some state or nodes, some labeled arc from one state to the next state, through which it will move. So we have number of states are there and number of labeled arc are there. So starting from N1, we are going through all these states, and at the end we are finding N7. Means if we have an example, for example, a transition network is used to recognize a sentence consists of an article, noun, auxiliary verb, verb, article, noun. Okay, these are the things. Means if we have a sentence as input, then we can identify in a sentence which term is an article, which term is a noun, like this. Okay, because the sentence should follow the English linguistic. These are the things. This type of system is used for making the system like Lunar. Lunar is a system which who uses that particular transition network. There are two types of transition network. First one is recursive transition network, that is known as RTN, and another one is augmented transition network, that is ATN. In a transition network, we are going through the overview of a sentence, that the sentence can be generated from that particular state. But when we go for RTN or ATN, then we go for particular stage. Means a sentence can be generated by noun stage and verb, noun phrase and verb phrase. Same as another transition network we draw for noun phrase, another transition network we draw for verb phrase. Okay. Okay. This is the transition network we have, which is used for, please go through it. A transition network may consist of some state or nodes. These are the state and nodes, and some labeled arc from one state to the next state through which it can move. So these are the states and these are the labeled arc. By using these labeled arc, we are moving from one state to another state, like this. Okay. And the, for example, the transition network is used to recognize a sentence consist of these things. Okay, so the transition network is used to recognize a sentence or to revert back the query of a sentence. Okay, this type of system is known as transition network. This is an example of finite state automata. Okay, transition network, it is based on the application of directed graph and finite state automata that you have already done in your automata, finite state automata, where we have finite number of state and we have labeled arc. By using these labeled arc, we can traverse the number of states. This type of diagram is also called finite state automata. Okay, so the basics of transition network is the finite state automata. Then I have already told you there are two types of transition network. So these are the types of transition network. The first type is recursive transition network, that is RTN, and another one is augmented transition network. Okay, RTN and ATN. These are the two types of transition network. The first one is recursive transition network, that is RTN. RTN consider as development of finite state automata. Again, the transition network derived from the finite state automata and graphical representation. So the both types of transition network, that is RTN and ATN, have the same definition, that they are developed for finite state automata with some essential condition, because they are two different types of transition network. So these two have two different properties. To explain this, in recursive transition network, the node consists of some states and label arc. States are the same as transition network, and label arc are the transitions. Okay, it permits arc to refer to another network, and they in turn may refer back to the referring network rather than just permitting word category. Okay. In the recursive transition network, and as name implies, when we are going from one state to another state, it can be reverted back. The transition network might have a loop back. Means if you are going from one state to another state, then it can go backwards to the previous state also. That type of network is called recursive transition network. There are five type of arcs. First one belongs to the cat. Cat means current word category. Second one is word. The word is the collection of word where we have all the words which are which available for the sentence. Then push. Push means when we are going from one state to another state, which new state we are getting. That is the push. Jump means the labeled arc. Or the arc which we are using for going to one state to another state. This is the term which we are getting, that is the post. This is the labeled arc which is used to derive the post article, and the pop. Pop is going for the loopback article, because when we want to go back, then we have to pop one state, then we go back. This is known as pop. Okay. For example, if we have the store watch dark black, this is the sentence, and we have to make a recursive transition network for this. Then in that particular sentence, the semantic is the is an article, stone is a noun, and watch is a verb, and dark is an objective. Dark black, again, this is adjective and a noun. Okay, then for making the RTN of that particular sentence, what we have to do, we have two things. First one is noun phrase. In that particular sentence, we have a noun. Stone is a noun, so we can generate a noun phrase, and we have only one verb, so the verb can be derived from the sentence. So using the noun phrase, how the noun phrase is derived, we have a noun phrase. That noun phrase can be generated from the article or from the adjective, because the dark black is a sentence where black is a noun and dark is a adjective. So dark black is a sentence which is derived from a noun phrase which is derived from adjective and noun. So the noun phrase can be derived from either adjective or a noun, and the is an article and stone is a noun. So again, the noun phrase from this, these two terms, we can generate a noun phrase that belongs to an article and an adjective. That's why we have mentioned here article and adjective, because a noun phrase is generated followed by the adjective and another noun phrase which is followed by the article. Okay, by using these two states, we can generate the noun phrase. Then after applying the one of them, we can find the first noun phrase. Okay, because we have two noun phrases in that particular sentence. The first one is the stone and second one is dark black. These are the two noun phrase we have. So the first noun phrase is generated by using an adjective, and second noun phrase we can generate first noun phrase we can generate by using article, and second noun phrase we can generate by adjective. And then pop means we have halted our procedure for generating noun phrase. Then we go for sentence. In the sentence, that sentence is derived from first, that sentence is derived from the noun phrase. Okay, first we have to use the stone, means the article and noun, that will make a noun phrase. Then the verb, or the helping verb we can say it, then the verb. So the noun, first we have a noun phrase, then the verb we have, then the noun phrase, and then halt. Okay, like this. First we have noun phrase, then we have verb. Okay, first we have noun phrase, then we have verb, we have again noun phrase, and then halt. This is the procedure of deriving the particular sentence by using RTN. And this is the table where the all state has been derived. The current is the state which have all the semantics. Either we are generating a sentence, either we are generating a noun phrase, or noun phrase one, noun phrase two, sentence one, sentence two, all these things are given there. Do not worry about this, because it has elaborated this table too much, because we have a very small sentence, so we can minimize that table into few states. Okay, from starting from sentence, we do not have anything, because the sentence followed by only noun phrase, because at the first when we make the sentence, that we have only a noun phrase which is derived. So at the first we have a sentence, then the sentence, the noun phrase is the part of sentence one, because this is the first state of sentence. That's why we are calling it S1. Okay, this particular sentence is derived from S1, S2, S3 and so on. So this is the particular sentence have the first part is noun phrase, means the stone is the first part of sentence, that is S1. Then we have verb. This is the second part of sentence. Second part of sentence means the stone was. This is the second part. Then the third phrase is the stone was dark. This is okay, like this. So we can derive the sentence like this. This is again the architecture of that sentence. When we go for the sentence we have, we can follow auxiliary, we can follow the auxiliary verb, or we can follow the noun phrase to find out S1 or S2. Then after implementing the noun, the verb, we are going to S3, or after implementing the noun phrase, we are going for that state. This is the diagrammatic representation of RTN. Okay, then, okay, we have only 10 minutes left. Then we have augmented transition network. Augmented transition network is also modification of RTN. Okay, in RTN, we have only two things, that the first one is sentence, second one is noun phrase, and the preposition phrase that we have appended here, but we do not need that preposition phrase in that particular, for that particular sentence, because we do not have any preposition in that sentence. But in augmented transition network, we make the system or the transition diagram for every state. Either we have sentence, noun phrase, preposition phrase, or verb phrase also. So this is the example of noun for that particular augmented transition network, that is RAM 8 and Apple. This is an example. So we have to find out the subject according to noun phrase, according to RTN, we have to find out some states and some these, the sentence, noun phrase, preposition phrase. These are the things which we have to identify, because these are the parts of a RTN. In the same, as the same in ATN, we have also the same parts of because this is the extension of RTN, so states are same, sentence, noun phrase and preposition phrase. But when we go for identification of these things, then we have to find out the states, means which are the states which we have. So the diagram is same, but the states which are maximum possible, that these are derived in the augmented transition network. You have to go through this theory that is written here. If you have any problem, then you can ask, because this is self-explanatory. This is not so much complex, because if you have done automata, then it is easy to find out. So when we derive the sentence, we have S, then we have subject. S is the sentence which is derived from the subject, that is the Ram. Then 8 is the variable. Okay, so 8 is the verb. Then we have an article N, and then apple. So the sentence is derived in the by using parts of speech, means first we have subject, and subject is a noun phrase according to semantic, and then noun phrase is the name of a person, that is Ram. Then we have a main verb, that is 8. Then we have 8 is the verb, but the verb have the particular tense, that is the past tense, because the present tense of 8 is eat. So we have the particular, the verb has a particular tense, that is the past tense. Then we have then article, that is then that he has mentioned as an object. This is the delimiter for a noun phrase, that is N. Then at the end, we have the head of that sentence, that is an apple. We can also make it like this. First, we have sentence, that is Ram. Then we have verb like 8, and 8 has the tense, that is past tense. Then we have an article, that is N. And then we have a noun, that is apple. Okay, this is the representation of ATN, augmented transition network. The difference between the augmented transition network and the RTN is, it do not go through the tense or the state of the verb, the RTN. Okay, the RTN do not go for the tense, which particular tense that verb belongs, or all these things which are deeply explain the sentence. But the ATN is also going through these things, like we have done in preposition logic and predicate logic. The quantified sentence are there in predicate logic, but not in there. But no, was not in prepositional logic. Same as for semantic and partition semantic net. In semantic net, we have just the semantic or graphical structure of sentence, and in partition semantic net, we make a general statement class and derive an object of GS. Then the GS will denote the quantifiers, that for all or there exist quantifiers like this. Same as for RTN and ATN. RTN is the graphical representation of state and arcs, which are maximum possible states for deriving a sentence, for deriving a noun phrase, for deriving a preposition phrase. And ATN is also the architecture which is used in lunar system. Okay, this is the lunar system, is the artificial intelligence system which implements the natural language processing, and the ATN is used to derive the particular structure of Luna. Okay. This is the ATN structure. Okay, one of you has to, Chirag is there, one of you has to send me your attendance, the screenshot of your all the participants who are present in there, because we have, I think, 22 students are there. So kindly send me the attendance in the group, so I will mark. Okay, or if go through these notes, I will send the link to you, that particular link which is available for this, and go through it, RTN and ATN and the transition network. And with that, if you have any query regarding any question, I think when we have class, then we can do all the missing, or we can repeat these topics, like conceptual dependency is one of the topic. When we have done this topic in class, we have very few students available. So I think this is one of the question that you might ask. Okay, we will go through it. I think I have to touch this because we have 2-3 minutes. Okay, in conceptual dependency, what we do in conceptual dependency, we go for the concept of the sentence. Okay, I do not have the PDF file here, so we will go in any other lecture. But remember, in conceptual dependency, we go for the concept which is used for deriving the particular sentence. Like, he is eating an apple. Eating is a concept which derived from a particular primitive act. There are four primitives and number of primitive act, like ingest. Ingest means anything when we are eating and drinking, that is known as ingest. Okay, when something going into our mouth, that is called ingest. Like, I am teaching you via a online mean or in a class, or I am giving you the notes. All these things are the mental information transfer. So this is known as mTrans. If you are moving somewhere, that comes in a category that is known as propel. So pTrans. So go through these notes. You can identify. There are some rules to make that conceptual dependency. If you have any problem, then you can post. I will make another video or another session for this. Okay. So with that lecture, I think we have completed unit 3 also, natural language processing. One and two topic are missing from the lectures that you have to go through yourself, like sentence generation, that is derived from all these topics which we have already done. So this is your post assessment. I will give you the Google form for this pre-assessment and post-assessment. Pre-assessment you have already done. Post-assessment is your assignment for unit 3. Natural language processing will be your post-assessment. Then we start the unit 4, fuzzy logic, from tomorrow. Okay, from tomorrow lecture we will go for fuzzy logic. That is the most important unit for all of you, fuzzy logic, because, and prerequisite for that fuzzy logic, that you have to go through the CRISP or the classical set theory. Okay, just complete the classical set theory, then proceed for fuzzy logic. I will make prerequisite for that Google form, and I will send it to you. And please go through that Google form. And again, please send me the attendance. If you have any one of you, can take the screenshot of all the students who are available and send me this. Okay, we have total 22 participants. And this is the last minute of this. We are running out of time. So please send me the attendance, okay? Thank you. And if you have any query, then you can post, please. Okay, thank you.